Hey everybody, Jill here. I'm going to do a quick overview of how I use a Google Sheet for my programmatic SEO. Just to give you an update, I am new to programmatic SEO. I did a post on LinkedIn and I also have another video, which I will link to in the comments of this video, about my launch into it. I did upload 50 posts in early December, and then I did another 50 at the end of December, and so far it's looking really good. The posts I uploaded early December have all been indexed. They are starting to show an increase in impressions. The ones at the end of December have not all been indexed yet, but they are just starting to, so I'm pretty excited about where this is going. How you approach this is really up to you. There's a million different ways to do programmatic SEO. I am not a risk taker when it comes to sites I care about, which I did test this on a site I really care about. So I did not go all in. I'm doing it in slow batches. So how you decide to do it is going to be depend on your circumstances. I do know a lot of people are uploading thousands of articles and are doing okay. I also know people who have uploaded thousands of articles and their sites have plummeted. So I think it has a lot to do, you know, with the quality of the content, the age of the domain, how much authority you have in the niche you're in. So those are all things you really need to consider. So with that said, I'm just giving you the caution warning. This is my approach to how I do programmatic SEO. I do use WordPress All Import. It is a fantastic plugin. They are planning to go to an annual subscription model. So right now I think you can still buy it as a one-time fee. So if this is something you're passionate about, I would really recommend buying the one-time fee if you're going to do programmatic SEO. So this is how I do it. So I'll think about the process. What do I want to do my programmatic SEO on? For this tutorial, I just decided on, okay, I have a vegan blog and I want to create a list of vegan restaurants in each state. So I do a little manual research. Maybe I create a custom post type in my WordPress admin for restaurants. And then I can have tags for city and state. Then what I can do is create a short code. And this is all going to be important for the spreadsheet. And this is exactly what I did on my website, which is not a vegan website, but the practical use is exactly the same. I created a custom post type. I created categories to categorize them by city and state. And then I created a short code where I can just put in the city and state to pull in the posts. So those are the methods that I used to create mine. Then I would create this spreadsheet. So now I have all of my restaurants already in my admin. Now I need to create the pages to put those restaurants in. So I want to create a page for Montgomery, Alabama. I want to talk about some of the best restaurants in Montgomery, Alabama that are vegan. So I'm going to create a column for my state, column for my city. I added in the state nickname only because I like to give as many unique triggers to my content as I can. And this was an easy one because you could just copy and paste it into the spreadsheet. You can look online, you'll find, you know, copy paste list of nicknames, state nicknames. It's just an easy copy and paste. I don't have to type it. So think about, you know, the least amount of work you can do, the better. So I got my state, my nickname, my city, foods. So what I tried to do was find some popular foods in each state. So fried green tomatoes are a very southern thing. Vegan pasta bolognese, I just threw that one in there. It's not really a southern thing. I just put it in there. And then peach cobbler is a southern thing. Those could all be vegan. In California, avocado toast, California tofu spring rolls, or garlic ice cream. Those are all vegan things that are very popular in California. So I just wanted to customize it a little bit. And that's what I decided to go with, you know, some of the most popular vegan foods. Location, I just did southern and western. You know, if you're in New Jersey, you'll do eastern. You can do Kansas, you know, central. So just another little trigger to Google to make it unique and give them, you know, just a little more about the state. So now we get into the good stuff. This is just all input content. There's nothing fancy going on here. And you could have as many columns as you want, guys, to make it as unique as you need to. Okay, so these are my variable, what I call my variable columns. Now we're going to go over here. This will be the H1 or the title for the post. Okay, now when I click on this, watch what happens above. Okay, this is where the magic happens. What this is telling, this is just a function in Google Sheets, and it's telling Google, hey, take this text and merge it with the content in these cells. Okay. So my main H1 is going to be everything you want to know about vegan restaurants in, and then I'm telling it to pull from C2 and A2, which happen to be Montgomery, Alabama. Okay. And what do you see here? Montgomery, Alabama. How you pull this in, it's just comma, C2, comma, and then close it with a question mark. This comma is the space between these two, and then you have another element here for another variable. So that's all there is to this. So you're telling, you got all the instructions in here. This one looks a little more scary. Okay. So now we've got, there are so many amazing restaurants in C2, in Montgomery. Okay, can you see it here? Montgomery. And then Alabama is A2, and that's here. Okay. Then you can go on and customize some of the text here. And then B2 is Yellowhammer State. So that's the state nickname. Again, you know, it's just another trigger to Google that, hey, this is an article about Alabama. Okay. It has vegan foods like, okay, and this is the food cell, fried green tomatoes, vegan pasta, peach cobbler, fried green tomatoes. So it's pulling that in for us, which are all popular Southern culinary delights. Okay. So E2 is pulling from Southern culinary delights. So my intro post or my intro paragraph now has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 variables. So even if I use this introduction in all 50 states, at least there'll be 5 variables to make it a little bit unique. But what I personally do to even make it better, I try to create 5 unique introductions. So I might run to Jasper and say, hey, Jasper, write me some intros for articles about best vegan restaurants. That guy will give me 5 unique introductions. I'll add one here, one here, one here, one here, one here. So the first 5 states each get a unique one. And then I copy those. So every 5 will be different. Okay. So 5 will have 5 of the same. 5 will have 5 of the same. So it's not 50 having all the same. It's just, it'll wind up being 10 posts with the same introduction, but with 5 different variables. So I hope that makes sense. So you're just repeating 5 introductions 5 times. And I think that's what's going to help make it a little bit more unique. It's a little bit more time consuming to do it this way, but I think there is a lot of benefit to it. So that is my recommendation for that. So that's the introduction. So that could be, you know, my top paragraph after my H1. Then we have the first H2 on the page. So this is best vegan fast food in Montgomery, Alabama. Best vegan food in Montgomery, Alabama. C2, A2 are the variables. This is the intro after my first H2. Okay. So this only has 1 variable in it. Okay. So this is where you want to, you know, just change it up a little bit. Okay. And this is where I would put my short code. So now I have my list of restaurants. Hopefully you created something where you can add a short code that'll say, okay, go ahead and pull in all the restaurants that are vegan in Montgomery, Alabama. And it'll just give a nice little list. So that'll be another unique piece of content. Then you've got your H2, best gourmet vegan dining in Montgomery, Alabama. Okay. And then custom text here, which is 1 little variable. But then I did a second one here with a different. Okay. So that's all I do. And I'll just go on as, you know, much as I need to. I typically have 4 or 5 sections. So I'll have about 4 H2s. Again, competitive research is important here. And just so you see how easy it is. So say I wanted to add a new state. I'll do New Jersey, Garden State. And we'll do Trenton. And we're known for pork roll, which is not vegan, but I'm just going to put that in here. We're known for our tomatoes and we're known for blueberries and we're Eastern and that's it. So I got all my data entered. Now I can just copy this down. It's going to everything you want to know about vegan restaurants in Trenton. And we're going to copy this down and copy that down. Trenton, New Jersey. Top vegan restaurant picks. Oops. Short code we can put in there. Best gourmet. And it doesn't have to be short codes. If you'd rather just do it manually, you can just put your list in here. The only trouble is you can't format it in here. So that's the only downside to Google Sheets. You have to be careful because, like, if you do lists, I don't believe WordPress all import can import the HTML needed to make lists and things like that. So I haven't tested that yet because I like the short code option. So you might want to test that out before you actually spend all your time doing that. And then bring that down, and that's it. So now I have my programmatic sheet. And then what I do from here, export. I'm going to do CSV. And I'm going to show you how it looks. Okay, so now I'm going to upload it to my WordPress import. Just got to wait for this to update here. Sorry, for some reason it takes forever to come up. So this is my sheet. I'm going to import this. Okay, I'm going to do new items. I'll just leave it as posts for now. Continue to step two. And what's good about this, using WordPress all import is important because what might happen is your first batch may not do well. It may not get indexed. It may trigger duplicate content. And by using WordPress all import, it allows you to actually update the content as well. So like for every batch that I upload, I save my spreadsheet. And if I see something not working, I can easily just go to my spreadsheet and change things and just update the existing content. I don't need to redo everything. So maybe I just want to add a new block of content to customize it even more. I can do that. And instead of choosing new import, I can do, you know, rewrite an existing import, and it'll just totally change it. So this is how easy this is. So you can see it's kind of showing you a sample here. Okay, I'm going to continue to step three. And then drag and drop. This is all just drag and drop. So the title of my post is this. Didn't click. Wait, hold on, didn't take it. I wonder. It seems to be stuck with the, there we go. So you drag and drop. So that's my H1. And this is why it's important to kind of align your titles of your spreadsheet just so you can find them easily when you're doing this process. I don't have any images on this page. You can add images. I didn't even bother. And then you could do, I have ACF fields add-on. I do use ACF Pro. So I'll go ahead and do that. I'm not going to worry about that now. But that's all you have to do. You'll just drag and drop it into the different fields that you want. Click continue to step four, and then it's automatically uploaded and you have all your stuff on your website. So that's it for sample programmatic. If you have any questions, let me know. I tried to make this easy, but if you have any questions, let me know. I am going to share this sheet so you can just copy this code if you want to and leave any comments. I'll be glad to hear them, or if you need more help, let me know. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.